नेक्स्ट ईयर। गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
टॉपिक
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। माय नेम इज किरण इंगोले, रोल नंबर 19, एंड वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग अ टॉपिक, अ स्टडी ऑन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मैनेजमेंट इन Zomato Gold. Zomato is the fastest growing restaurant discovery application. It is founded by Pankaj Chadha and Dipender Goel. The Zomato CEO are Dipender Goel and Gaurav Gupta. Zomato do not provide only information about nearby restaurant and facilities. It is also provide online ordering, table reservation and management. Zomato was a successful in obtaining funding from a number of sources and expanded in India and overseas. Zomato's headquarters at Gurgaon, Haryana. Zomato serves in 24 several countries. Zomato have 5,000 plus employees. Zomato's revenue is 2,486 crore in 2020. This case discussed the conflict raised due to its gold membership scheme, which exploited the bottom line of registered restaurant. Under the scheme, which deep discounting to the customer, and the outcome of the issue, which affected its brand equity and market capitalization. Thank you. Over to Viplav.
Hello everyone. This is Viplav Kulkarni, roll number 97. So basically, Zomato Gold is a membership program in which the consumers get exclusive deals at gold tagged restaurants and bars across the country. The subscription of the Zomato Gold membership will also allow the consumer to order any two complimentary drinks like alcoholic or non-alcoholic. There are mainly two plans. One is for 6 months. It is available at 999 rupees, and another is for 1 year subscription, which is available at 1800 rupees. With Gold, Zomato Gold, customers enjoy multiple benefits on dining out. There are many benefits on dining out, like up to 40% off, in which one free dish and two free drinks are available. The benefits are applicable on dining out at partner restaurants. To unlock the benefits, open the restaurant page on the Zomato app and show your phone to the staff before placing your order to enjoy Zomato Gold experience. This Zomato Gold membership is available at different big cities like Pune, Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rohit Lawan. I will talk about the main objective of Zomato Gold. So the first objective is Zomato wanted to compete with the dominant player Swiggy and expand its market. So it was Zomato Gold was launched in the year 2017. Initially it was launched in Delhi, Mumbai and Bangalore. So at that time Swiggy was clocking approximately 1 million more online orders per month than Zomato. So Zomato wanted to compete with Swiggy and expand its market. The second objective is it wanted its partner restaurant to benefit. So through this scheme, the Zomato wanted that the footfall at its partner restaurant would increase, and that would eventually increase the revenue of the restaurant. So the Zomato thought that it would act as a very lucrative offer for the restaurants who are not the partner of Zomato in this scheme. The third objective of Zomato Gold was that it wanted to increase the number of loyalty customers. So we know that Indian market is driven by the low cost and discount and competitive pricing market. So there is no concept of loyal base of customers in this segment of food market. So by launching Zomato Gold, Zomato wanted to bring the loyalty factor into the play. Important to develop its loyal base of customers which would not mind higher prices, etc. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Rohan. Good evening, ma'am. My name is Gaurav Patil. I am presenting you the teaching objective. First one is to evaluate the new Zomato Gold scheme launched by the Zomato and to get to know what company has to offer to the customers and what they have to offer to the restaurant owners. Second is understand the different issues and the challenges faced by the restaurant owners and partners in operating during the Gold Membership Scheme conflict experience in 2019. Third is understand the challenges in operating a platform business, particularly in the food service sector. And last one is to identify the challenges and explore the strategy that the company can adopt in future. Thank you. Over to you, Aditya.
Yes. Hello. Good evening, ma'am. My name is Aditya Bhogve. I'll be talking about the subscription of Zomato Gold. So basically,
yeah, any network issues?
But in the bit of gold bonds, it was a bit. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are. Continue.
Okay, so basically, when Zomato launched its product, that is Zomato Gold, so the people in front of them, like the hotel owners, were not expecting Zomato to, like, they were expecting some premium customers and not the regular customers. But then Zomato launched its subscription for like everyone, and the expectation was against the owners of the restaurants. But anyway, it was a win-win situation for everyone, the customer, the restaurant owners, as well as the Zomato Gold in the beginning. As the Zomato launched its gold product, the restaurant owners saw a lot of hike in their sales, as well as 12% increase on the weekends in their sales of the food products. And also the person, like the customer, he got one-on-one dish free, as well as two-on-two drinks free. So even he was in a win-win situation, as well as Zomato Gold got its, as well as Zomato Gold got its profit margin good. So therefore, it was a win-win situation for every one of them. And there were like almost 2 lakh subscriptions, over 2 lakh subscription within the first 6 months launch of Zomato Gold. Now I'll hand over to Neha. Thank you.
So in the next slide, we can see some statistics which indicates weekdays and weekends. So basically, like as we know, like Zomato is providing a lot of discounts, free dishes, like one-on-one and two-on-two drinks, like alcoholic, non-alcoholic. So, like as compared, like we can see in the statistics, like with the help of Zomato Gold, the statistic has been increased by 30%. Like we can see on weekends, without Gold membership, people walking in the restaurant were only 70%, and with Gold membership, it went to almost 80%. So we can see the hike in people visiting the restaurants with the Gold membership. Yeah, over to you, Krishnali.
Sorry, ma'am. I'm Krishnali Raut, and my topic is research methodology. In this, while researching, we saw boom membership plans and subscription model in the market. Since this was the first ever membership plan Zomato was coming up with, there is two scenarios. Like for the, you all, you can enjoy the gold benefits anytime and on any days. Membership will be let you visit any the gold partner restaurants that's like you. You just open the Zomato app, log in into it, and search for the gold restaurant, visit it, and enjoy your foods and drinks. Over to you.
Thank you, Krishnali. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening to everyone. I'm Kaustubh Subhash Akulwar, role number 69, and I will be discussing about the conflicts and challenges faced with the introduction of the Zomato Gold. We have to know that with the introduction of Zomato Gold, there was a subsequent increase in the revenue. From the figure, you can see there is an abrupt increase in the revenue of Zomato in the fiscal year 19 as compared to 18. So what happened in 19 that made the revenue to increase abruptly? This was the time, as Aditya told, when Zomato decided to give subscription to each and every customer. So what were the conflicts and challenges faced by the restaurant owner? I mean, the revenue was good, everything was fine. So what were the conflicts? So the conflicts were, the restaurants then started in a war in deep discounting amongst themselves. Also, customers were exposed to wider choices, convenience, and greater choices, and in turn often switched loyalties. This then questioned the sustainability of the restaurants. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, hello ma'am, this is Abhishek. So as I have talked about challenges faced by restaurants, so if we see in a very simple way, I have collected some information from NRAI, which is National Restaurant Association of India, in which they have said a very simple thing that all the restaurants have to pay to Zomato for including themselves into the Golden Membership, which was like initially Zomato had started the membership, that Zomato Gold, for only 5,000 elite members, and there were only few restaurants, like two or three restaurants, to which Zomato used to send invitation, and they were joined. But after that, Zomato started using this elite membership program as an instrument to increase sales, which impacted the restaurant sales very badly. So what happened was that after doing this, in an year itself, Zomato had sold around 1 million memberships, according to which, and it had started charging restaurants as well, which was around 25,000 plus GST. So a restaurant owner has to pay this much amount of money to the Zomato to enter into Zomato Gold. And because Zomato people used to say that if you won't be joining the Zomato Gold program, so it will be a FOMO, which is fear of missing out. So you won't be getting that much footfall which other restaurants are getting. So in the competition, all the restaurants were, what we can say, mentally, like they were, okay, so we have to go into this. And they just moved in into that Zomato Gold membership. And that thing happened used to be like, if you are coming to a restaurant owner will be providing you something free, or 50% discount, or buy one, get one free offers, which will be adapted by the Zomato Gold people. So now in this case, most of the customers were coming and they were having their food there, they were having their meal like mostly free, due to which it was impacting hugely and very badly on restaurants. But restaurants could not do anything because, as we say, they had a fear of missing out for the crowd which they expected in other restaurants as well. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. This is Prakipar Purka, roll number 85, and I'm here to elaborate the disadvantages. Yes, good evening, ma'am. I'm here to elaborate the disadvantages and limitations of Zomato Gold. As we all can see, there are quite a few disadvantages to Zomato Gold. Let's start with this. At least two dishes need to be ordered in order to get one free. And even after ordering five or six dishes, the number of free dishes remain to one. Same happened with the drinks, wherein at least two drinks needed to be ordered in order to get two more free. One of the biggest disadvantages with Zomato Gold is that it is only available in top cities in India. Zomato Gold is also giving deep discounts, which is affecting the bottom line of the restaurants very adversely. Also, the new restaurants are forced to use it in order to make a name for themselves in the market at very low to none profits. And lastly, ma'am, a new version of Zomato called Zomato Pro is now launched that offers up to 25% discount on the total bill, even on the home delivery, which needs to go through a Zomato getaway, which again charges a fee to the restaurant owners. These are few of the major disadvantages of Zomato Gold. Thank you.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, friends. Okay, after listening to the foundation, progress and limitations of Zomato Gold, let's see what's the upcoming future of Zomato Gold. Okay, in case of future scope, reaching the rural areas is very difficult where such many restaurants in such areas are not available as such. And secondly, the engagement of restaurants to Zomato is quite poor. Secondly, Zomato should widen the range of service by through aggressive advertising measures. Okay. Secondly, this process of fake review systems can be avoided. How? Okay. The review system can be assured as true by Zomato by rewarding the reviewers with discounts and coupon codes on food products and food packages. Okay. Thirdly, the photos on Zomato Gold displayed about the ambience and the food might not be exactly the same as it is on the location. For to remove the all the problems of the customers and make it and to make it easier for them, provide a like a live video or short recording about the ambience and kitchen of the restaurant itself. And thirdly, okay, sometimes customers find it difficult to find the location. What Zomato Gold can do is provide a possible landmark photo or a possible video in the Zomato Gold page of restaurants and pubs, which makes it easier for the customers to find it out. Thank you. Over to Krish. Over to Vanshika.
Hi, good evening. The suggestions for Zomato, to improve Zomato Gold is the economics and customers warm the improve unit economics as customers warm the food delivery more. Zomato is making more money per order since restaurants make percentage of order value. The company is also reducing subsidies and discounts to users gradually, which has led to sharp increase in the company's margins. New innovation in plans are suggested for Zomato Gold. We come to conclusion. With seeing all the slides, we come to a conclusion that there was an increase in customer purchases and customer loyalty. Zomato partner restaurant had 3x more traffic than compared to non-Zomato Gold partners. Gold offered great value to customers as well. New restaurants were discovered by customers. Dining out became more affordable. Thank you. This presentation was brought to you by Group 8.
So, yes. I want to see your faces, please. Switch on your videos. Yes. So anyways, thank you so much for a nice presentation. At least I came to know what Zomato is all about. And if I want, I can also order something from Zomato. But during COVID, it is very difficult. We are not supposed to order, right? But yeah, questions. I have few questions, one or two questions at least. The first and foremost question is, do you think Zomato Gold should be continued? Zomato Gold scheme. Do you think it should be continued? Why? And why? Okay. So if you're giving me a answer, you need to say why. Okay. Secondly, do you think the way Zomato is actually torturing, you can say, the restaurant people, is it correct?
No, ma'am. Zomato Gold should not be continued because not good for business actually. They started with initially offering limited people the gold membership, but eventually expanded, so it harms the business. And I think they have stopped the Zomato Gold program and they have rebranded it to Zomato Pro last year. With some changes, major changes. So I think it was good that they closed the program.
Okay. And secondly,
ma'am, I would like to say that from a customer's point of view, Zomato Gold should be continued. But if we look at it from a restaurant owner's point of view, it is a very lossable deal.
So, ma'am, if we see in the restaurant perspective.
restaurants perspective, so most of the restaurants in India right now, they have literally boycotted Zomato Gold. There is a huge andolan or something going on on the social media as well, from the side of restaurant owners, that they are boycotting all the kind of like Zomato Gold or Dine Out or any kind of apps which are providing discounts for the customer, for the restaurant. So all the restaurant owners, they are boycotting it from that.
I think, ma'am, the restaurants were pressurized at that time with the introduction of Zomato Gold, as Aditya told about the GST and all they have to pay. And after the logout movement happened, firstly 1200 customers, the hotels logged out from the Zomato Gold. So still Deepinder Goyal, the CEO of Zomato, did not change the policy. He issued a legal notice, as they were into the bonds, the restaurants were into the bonds. So he issued a legal notice to join back, to log in back. So I think there he was wrong, Deepinder Goyal. He should have thought about the dual aspect of this, this.
Right.
This scheme.
So when you are launching something, you should be also thinking about the other person's benefit. Now, customers benefit. See, customer is benefiting every time. See, nowadays, what has happened is one restaurant is giving you some kind of discount. Other restaurant goes and gives you another counter kind of discount. Right.
Yes, ma'am.
So that's okay. But since the most who was suffering is the restaurant owners, right? Because they also want profit. But the kind of thing what Zomato is doing, it is more or less like if I should put in, it's like a dadagiri, right? Yes, like, if you don't do this, we are like, you won't be having this much foothold. So this is not the way how you should be inserting a fear factor in the minds of the restaurant owner, right?
No, after all, even that from is their the customer business.
Hmm.
I mean, from the customer point of view, if you think, then this program was not good, because on a lighter note, if you think that people will keep ordering things and eating, so it will impact their health, because if we ultimately think, then the outside food is not good for our health.
Yeah, that is okay. And many kind of articles have also come about Zomato, that recent fight. That was one article. Second is the Zomato, the service people, like half of the time, they just open the packet and they eat and they send it. So there were so many articles on that also. So is it actually healthy? So that is one thing which needs to be seen. And if you really want to go for a big chain or something like that, better to keep everyone with you, right?
Yes.
See, profit making, in a business, everyone thinks about profit making, no doubt. But I shouldn't be the only person who should be getting the profit. And the poor person who has having his own restaurant, his place and everything, here it is sheer thing of manipulation, right? What they were trying to manipulate. A fear factor, a manipulation. Obviously, if I have a business, I would definitely think that, okay, let many customers come. In that bargain, if I get less profit, it's okay. But if you see the restaurant owner, they are spending so much money on the location. They're spending so much money on the building, on the staff and everything. Now, if they are not getting that much profit, that means like it is just a kind of a sheer wastage. And on top of that, you are just going and, telling them, issuing legal notices and all those stuff, which is not correct. It is actually against the business ethics.
Also, right? They were, involved in a banter with the NRAI, National Restaurants Authority of India. They were involved in the banter, and it was clearly mentioned by NRAI that Zomato is because of restaurants. Restaurants are not because of Zomato. So that was the point
that's
mentioned.
True. That's true. Because if
also,
there is
the concept of loyal customer is going on a declining. prior to this, people had their favorite restaurant that they used to visit frequently. Restaurants had their loyal customers, but because of these discounts, people just tend to go to new place because they are offering more discounts than the loyal places. That is also,
and even the quality needs to be seen also, and Zomato for one, like if you see most of the cases, if you see this delivery thing, food delivery and all these things, most of the cases would be against Zomato, because every now and then you'll find certain cases. So that means something is really wrong.
And this scheme is really wrong. This scheme shouldn't be continued, but it was a very good, it was good for hotels, as they wanted to, you know, wanted more customer base, the ones which had started new. So it was good for a limited period of time, but after a certain period of time, when it started exploiting the owners, then that time it became a bit...
They were more inclined towards
the opposite way. I agree with Aditya. There were also customers who were misusing Zomato Gold. Like they were allowed, like 3-4 people were allowed to use Zomato Gold on the same table. So the restaurants were facing crisis. They were not getting enough profit, and as they were giving services, and there were less profit. So even the staff were facing issues with Zomato Gold.
Right. So these are the basic things, right? Hello? So which nowadays away and all those stuffs are like, you know, food takeaways and all those are now losing their popularity because of COVID and all those. And most of the people have realized that, you know, should be having at least hygiene food. Now, like students like you who have got no choices, you're staying in hostel if you don't know how to cook. So that's a different thing altogether. Like certain bachelors also, if they don't know how to cook, so that's a different issue. But if you have a family, you're staying with your family, what I would suggest that the less food you have from outside is very good for your health, right? It would be hygienic also if you're cooking food. If it's only a dal and rice, I think that would be also good enough. But at least have home food.
I think
having food from outside will...
This conflict will always be there between the emerging tech companies and the brick and mortar restaurants or shops, etc. As they grow, both the business models are different, so they will conflict at one point or another.
Conflict would be there, but what I want to say is, like, when you are going for certain kind of scheme, you should be at least thinking about the other person as well. So in the starting, they thought about the people, but later on, like, they became very greedy. They wanted to have the entire cream, right? They didn't want to share anything with anyone. So that was the greatest disadvantage.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, only 7 minutes are left. So should we rejoin?
No. It's okay. I have finished. I'm just discussing with you. So I've given you marks. I've given you everything. So don't worry. So anyways... It was nice talking to you and listening to your views and discussion. And I can see all of you are actually becoming very good in research. So, you know, Dadas sir would be very happy. Naval Wadia would be very happy that we have 120 researchers with us. Okay. So, whomsoever you think, you know, you want to do research with, you can come and join and write research papers. So I'm really happy. The project has come out really well, and you people are actually, you know, finding interest in this, so which is a very good thing. And at least
all thanks to you.
Factor, yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
All thanks to you. Because of you, we did.
Ma'am, because of this project, the coordination among the team was very good. Because of such projects, the coordination among the team was increasing, improving. That's a good sign for us.
Right.
For us.
Yes, ma'am.
So now you have some good friends, and like, you know, so at least like till second year, you can do lots of things.
The best thing was that everyone was taking care of everyone. So it was not like no one got a feeling of left out. That was the best thing about the whole team.
Yes. So everyone was given chance to contribute. Everyone was given a chance to speak. So that's good enough. So that is what team is all about. Leadership quality is all about. Now, if you have a good leader with you, everything falls in place. Right? Do you agree to this?
Debate thing.
Our leaders are very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, I didn't get you. Yes.
Ma'am, the debate, ma'am, the debate which was going to happen on 14th April, is it still happening?
Yeah, that I like was telling you people, like I had called up Onkar also to send a message in the group. Actually, since I have joined newly in Wadia, so today I came to know that the subjects which are at the university level, like OB, right? It's a university label. So what we are supposed to do is like, you know, to like we can take up assignment and all those, but the marks won't be counted. Are you getting me? It would be only for a practice. It's like, you know, like for the internal subjects, the marks would be counted, like 50 marks from our end and rest would be from, like, you know, university. Your 50 for the assignments and other marks would be from your exam, right? University. So here marks are not being counted. So it would be for a practice purpose. So you people decide and tell me what exactly you want. I leave it to you.
And we can have a debate without the PPT.
With it. We are all good with it.
And can we have the debate without the PPT?
We could have some kind of different activities with different groups, as we already have the same groups everywhere. So maybe a change of members would make us, like, it creates a lot of
fun. So what I was suggesting, you know, what I was suggesting, instead of having it for 5 days, we can go for a 1 day where all the team pick up your best 2 or 3 people, right? We want 24 members, right? If you see for and against, right? So each member, like if you could pick up 2 or 3 like best, and you can, you know, fight, battle it out. So that
would be
a kind of
better offline, because virtually, like, taking so many people, it gets complicated.
No, but ma'am, it will won't it become a chaos if like 8?
Tell me.
I guess it will, ma'am. I think it will get become bit chaos if a lot of teams are coming together.
You have 10 groups, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And
for
2
people
from each.
One group and make it 24 members like we were supposed to have. Are you getting me?
Yes, ma'am. But the thing is, when even if there is a debate of 2 groups, still, like, it's like hardly someone gets a chance to speak because people are just hammering. And then if, like, 10 groups
what are moderators
come together,
for? We are the moderator, right? What will the moderator do if you people are hammering everyone?
Ma'am, there was a debate.
Group discussion is better.
Where groups had a chance to debate on topics for and against, but people speaking, 6 people speaking at a time, and no one, like half the people had good points. Someone else took it, or else someone didn't get the chance to speak, and someone was like, okay, give me some time to speak, and someone was cutting them off. Someone was not able to explain their points. This was going on the whole time, but mostly half of the time.
We would want to have different activities, like we get more exposure.
Ma'am, that was a good activity for like confidence wise and improving coordination wise. That was a good activity, but all we are saying that such an activity that each and every person gets to contribute the same or more, not only one guy gets to speak and everyone is like just listening and can't even explain his points. Not that, like everyone gets same. Yeah.
Okay, so you people discuss with yourself and just let me know. Okay, discuss with 120 people and let me know.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Take care.
Bye.